So you know this notion of equality of opportunities versus equality of outcomes?
Right.
Typically, we link it to all of the woke stuff, right? So equality of opportunities is great. Equality of outcomes is a cancer to human dignity. Okay. Let's now apply that concept, equality of outcomes, to war casualties. So I think this is what happens when people say, oh, but the IDF is being grotesque, because the currency that then matters becomes how many dead on each side, equality of outcome. But let me change it to a different moral currency, okay? Let's talk about intent. So for example, in the justice system, you could have a person who is found guilty of involuntarily vehicular homicide, and he kills four people, okay? So four are dead. So that's equality of outcome. Four were died versus someone who took out a hit on his entire family, his brother, sister, and parents, so that he can win the insurance money. But it's an undercover operation. The cops catch you. Even though in that case there were zero killed, correct? That person will get a higher sentence because we understand in the law that intent matters. So now I think you know where I'm going with the analogy. So in the Palestinian IDF conflict, when, say, Hamas launches 6,000 rockets, every single one of which is intercepted by the Iron Dome, had they not had the Iron Dome, then the outcome could have been that 50,000 would have been killed, right? In an ideal world, from Hamas's perspective, our intent would be to eradicate every last Jew. They have it in their charter. So yes, it is true that if we just count the number of people who were killed on October 7th versus the number who were killed in the retaliation, if that's the only calculus that matters, then, oh yes, the IDF has gone way overboard. But once you change it to an existential intent issue, then maybe it's not such as bad of an outcome as you think, notwithstanding that a single innocent dead is a tragedy.
That's, you could say it that way, but the problem with that is the Iron Dome does exist, and Hamas's military capabilities are far below Israel's. It would be like if some small person tried to punch me, and I moved out of the way and then beat them to death. And I said, no, I had to defend myself. I beat them to death. But I didn't have to beat them to death. They're just a small person. Even if they hit me, it wouldn't really hurt me.
Right.
It's not, you know what I'm saying?
Sure.
Like, defensively, I'm not worried about a real small person that doesn't know how to fight, who throws a punch at me.
So what would be, in your moral calculus, the ideal outcome that should have happened as a retaliation to October 7th?
That's a very good question. Obviously, I'm not a military analyst. If I was... You know, you do have to take in consideration the tunnels. You do have to take into consideration the infrastructure. The question is, did they just knowingly bomb places where there was going to be hundreds and hundreds of innocent civilians, knowing that there's going to be a few Hamas?
Yeah.
And that's what scares people. What scares people is that someone is willing to kill women and children just to get at bad guys, and they just say that's just part of the game. That seems horrific in the 2024 understanding of human life and morality and just the horrors of war. That, you know, they're blowing up mosques, they're blowing up schools, they're blowing up apartment buildings, everything, anything where they think Hamas is.
So again, let me preface, and I shouldn't have to say this, that a single person killed that's innocent is a tragedy.
Of course.
But compare that reality to almost any other war that you have in working memory. Why is there a unique, unbelievably high threshold of morality that is placed on the Israeli nation, right? Now, you probably already know this. The IDF does go through a lot of painstaking effort to try to minimize that, right? They drop leaflets in Arabic. They even sometimes call people in Arabic and say, don't go in this area. They hold. So, of course, they've killed many, many innocent people. But they're placed between a rock and a hard place. What can you do, right? The other side knows exactly that if they do exactly what they're doing, either you don't retaliate and we win, or you retaliate very harshly as they have, and then you still win, right? Today, the propaganda war has been completely won by Hamas, right? There's a complete genocide in the informational war against the IDF, right?